the fastest who gets paid, and it's the fastest who gets late.
Oh, yeah. You know what I'm talking about.
Hello, Shalom Ha. What is going on, y'all? Alejandro, congrats on first. Sam the Painting Lady's here. How's it going? How is it going? This is me checking my captions. Oh, it works. Hey, let's go. How y'all doing today? I'm doing great. I hope you can hear me. I think you can. Yes, you can. What's that? Oh. Let's check on that bot. But while we do that, let's kick it on back and start the show. Hi. We hear you. So happy I'm catching a stream. I'm glad you're here. What's going on? How y'all doing? I'm resetting a bot really quick because I noticed it didn't work. Because that's fun. What are y'all doing today? Anything cool, fun, interesting, mundane, regular? Something that we need to know about? Hello! Cloudbot, there you are. Why are you off? What gives you the right to go on vacation without my permission? Bot? Julie! What's up? Welcome in. I'm gonna make chili today. Do y'all like chili? What's your favorite bean? Chilling, gonna eat some pizza and watch sports. I heard that the Philadelphia baseball team is going to the Super Bowl. Call me Kep. Hello, just finished watching some college football. Now ready to relax. What's up? One upsie, what's up? Hey, y'all. How are you? Happy Saturday. Started off with a standstill ball. And then it began to roll. And then we continued rolling. And now I'm here at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I don't know. Standard? Or is it daylight? I don't know. What day is it? Sunday? Yeah, probably. Looks like everything's working. Off topic, but Buff Cheese with the sword, by the way. Hey, Lando. Yo, thanks for the Prime sub. Look at this scary-ass Jeff Bezos. Bringing in the fleet. You know, I might pay a visit to Jeff Bezos in space this coming Thursday. Thanks for the 8 months, Lando. I appreciate that. Paint Scratcher actually drew Buff Cheese. I forget what I called it. Thor Gonzola. That's the name of that character. It's Thor Gonzola. I'm liking this setup, by the way. Thank you. I realize I haven't really turned on any of my cameras. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's try this one. Oh. Oh. Move you a little closer. Bring it in. Bring it in, y'all. Okay, we got the cutting board cam active now. You know what I haven't turned on? Is this. I haven't turned this on at all. So, let's see what happens there. But at least we got this going for us right now. I'll turn that off until I'm ready for it. Okay. Still a work in progress, by the way, y'all. Khalifa, welcome in. Yeah, hi, everyone. Hope you're having a nice day so far. Paint Scratcher is talented as heck for making Gorgonzola. No, not Gorgonzola. Thor Gonzola. Thor, like son of Odin. Ghibli! Wiggling in my chat. Wiggling on in here. What's up, yo? But you can, but you know where it's coming from, though. This angle is whack. I don't like it.
Come here.
I moved it a little bit. No. Yeah, it's pretty good. I don't know, man. I don't like that this is here now. I had it in a different spot before. Yes, Thor Gonzola. Yeah, get it right. Get your deity right, because we are subscribing now to a newsletter, an email chain, if you will, where I will invite you to various cooking streams. Oh, wait, you already joined the Discord. Thank God. appreciate y'all being here. Hope it's not too close to the stove. It's not. It's not. Heat goes like, eh. And this one, I just don't even use this burner. But also, this was off camera before. I don't mind it being right in front. Also, it's not that bad to, like, see. I almost feel like this is a good angle for, like, instructional videos. You can kind of see what's going on here, but you don't need to see what's going on here, because I'll have another camera for that. You know what I mean? Now, here's a problem. The mouse is a key ingredient? No, it's not. I could always do it over here, because I can't. that is really far away. No, I can. But you can still see the wire, so there's no point. I moved the mouse over anyway. Oh, that's what I was doing. I had this idea like last week and then I forgot what I did. Oh my God. Give me 1 second. Put the stream deck in the chili. I will dip my deck directly in the chili. If you come at me like that. Give me a moment. I'm making moves. Okay? Is that Nurse Shani? Shani! How are you? Anyway, you're Risa. There you go. Thanks for the Risa. Thank you for getting a sub. To our pal, the painting lady. Talented. Art streamer extraordinaire. I'm still here. I'm still here, okay? Don't check it out. Hey. Please. 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 What about here? Was that just enough to get it out of the way? So what the heck are you doing? What the heck are you doing? What's up? How you doing? Nice new name, by the way. I haven't had a chance to tell you. I noticed. How are you? Watching you mess around with wires? Yeah, you're doing great. You're doing a great job watching me mess around with my setup. Just wanted to say that. I don't know if anyone's told you that this week, but I appreciate you. What's going on, everyone? Hi. I think I actually have a place to put my stream deck that's not totally weird. Well, now you can see it. But now you'll know where that the magic is happening somehow. I'll put my mouse away every so often. What's good? You're a chef streamer extraordinaire. Thank you. And also, thank you, Lando, for gifting a sub again. I don't know if you could hear me because I was over there. To Sam, the painting lady. Working my day off after moving my sister in. Well, I hope that it was not that bad of a move. And by not that bad of a move, maybe one couch, maybe a bed. You know, nothing too over the top. Hello? Sheik? Thanks for the raid! I just finished putting stuff away so that I can actually, like, talk to y'all. So what timing? What great timing, raiders. How are you? How are you doing, Inoshik? What's going on? What were you doing? Let me do a little shout out. But also, welcome in Just A Aria. Of course, Inushik and Fredster. What's going on? Let's see if my bot came back from vacation. They did! You're streaming some Elden Ring. Oh, hell yeah. What part of Elden Ring are you at? I'm okay with spoilers. I don't know if everyone else in chat is or not, but we're chilling. Everything sound okay? Music's not too loud, all that. We just finished our sound checks and our video checks. So it's good to see y'all. By the way, Raiders, hi. My name's John, also Cheese. I stream cocktail creation and cooking. Today I'm doing my secret chili recipe. That's a secret because I don't know what goes in it. But it's a secret to me. I have a general idea what's going to happen. All right. Everything sounds good. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Everything sounds good. Hell yeah. I'm just glad y'all are here. I hope you did something nice for yourself today. I hope that you are feeling all right. If you haven't done something nice for yourself yet, you still got time. Grab some water, which I'm about to do. Grab some coffee if it's not too late for you. Give yourself a snack and get yourself a treat because we're going to cook some food so that I can eat later. I also have a special announcement today in a little while about streams, and it's chili season. So you're going to see me put together my chili and my recipe live while everyone else will see only the best parts, which is boring, to be honest with you. You will get to see all this good stuff right away. Kind of all over the map right now. We're fighting Elamir in the Toxic Castle. Ooh. Well, anyway, thank you for bringing some raiders over. I know that if you had a stream, it was probably a long one. You might have to take care of yourself. You might have to shut things down. Maybe be quiet for a minute. Feel free to lurk. Feel free to take your time. Thank you so much for bringing some friends over. And everyone, go check out Inushik. They're a streamer, and they're playing Elden Ring, and I know a lot of you like Elden Ring. So if you like what you see, follows are free. Go check them out. Hell yeah. 1:40 a.m. coffee time. Let's go. Cheers. I'm going to start pulling ingredients out. We're going to say them out loud just so I have a bite of that. And also, I'm going to make sure that my overhead cam for this area is also functional in just a moment. And it was awesome. They made the best emote of all time. Thank you, Alejandro. That I couldn't have said it better myself. What is that emote? I actually can't see it from here. Feet. You know what I mean? You're so sorry. No. I thought it was good. I had to push a button. Yeah, I'm up here right now. Don't worry about it. Sorry. I had to focus in on something up there. Oh my god! Shoes in the house? Yeah. Styling. It's we're in work mode. I wear shoes when I want to get stuff done. Yeah, I know. It's probably a really controversial topic for a lot of people. Hi Ronnie. Thanks for the 10 bits. Damn cheese, that was a smelly one. Fragrant. Like a pumpkin spice candle. Freshly lit. You know what I mean? How are you? Welcome in. I was doing something. Who is vehemently opposed to wearing shoes in the house? Who wears shoes in the house? Because that's how they grew up. And who just goes barefoot? Who gets the grippers out, as you would say? You good? Just finished eating dinner? How you doing? I'm chilling. I'm just starting to pull out some ingredients and get motivated to make some chili. Thanks for coming by, y'all. Slash poll. Hello? Do I even know how to mod? Question. Feet? Question mark? No. Shoes in the house. Shoes in the house? Yes. Often. Yes. Rarely, though. No. Grippers only. Socks. Always. Duration? 2 minutes. Poll is up. These are important answers, okay? I think this is necessary to know. I think it's necessary to talk about. It's okay if you want to wear some shoes in the house. Put socks in there. Oh, yeah. I didn't even see that, Sam. I was just like, I feel like socks always is a thing. No shoes in the Asian household. Yeah, that makes sense. I mean, you know, it's all cultural tradition sometimes. Sometimes you wear fuzzy house slippers, though. Mostly barefooted. Oh, I need new slippers. Everyone that's listening, don't forget, winter and cold shit is about to happen. Get yourself some new slippers. It's time. I get the dogs out for the flip-flops. So the flip-flops got have the holes in them. Are they the thong ones? Where it's like, where you're like scissoring your sandals? Or are you getting the full like strapped up ones that you could go hiking in? This is a very important topic. Feet. Yeah, I know. You're the best. My feet are always freezing. We all need better circulation. Plus, we all need to stand up more often. Hey, bacon zits. Thank you. And also, hello. And cold shit. Yeah. I feel like socks but no shoes is just dirty. Well, you're like sweeping the floor, you know? Julia says that everyone in my house has house shoes. Ooh, nice clean heads or something. Thongs because we're cool. Hell yeah. Your socks mostly and shoes also. Oh, how's our poll looking? I got the poll up. You got a couple seconds. You probably are only gonna have like 2 seconds by the time you hear me say that. No grippers only Yes, often at a hard zero. Yes, rarely, though, with a one. Sox always is actually the winning option here. Sox always. Now, isn't that interesting? The one that was merely an afterthought turned out to be the most popular. Huh. On that note, silly socks are amazing. I have some silly socks on my gift to myself list, you know? It's just fun. It's just fun that way. I have clownfish ones are the ones that I'm working with. Let's try this. Hey, it works. Ooh, okay. We're going to go back, though, because that is the way. We have our overhead areas. Chili. It's named after one thing, and that's the spicy peppy. Fuzzy socks. Inward fuzzy or outward fuzzy? My fuzzy socks die within minutes of it existing. Your stream light out is cool. Thank you. Chili. We're going to have a nice little pun for our whiteboard here. I had one really bad pun for this. I still don't know what I want to do. I'm open to options. So I'm going to tell you the really bad one to give you an example of how you can do better than me. Netflix and chili. Because I just kind of want to watch a new anime and eat chili tonight. I need a new anime to watch on that note. As well. inward and outward give me comfy. All around fuzzy. Now, isn't that interesting? Right? I'm a big fan of that idea. I feel like we could get maximized comfort if we just go all-encompassing. Why not cover the earth in one fuzzy sock? Start Mob Psycho 100, please? I have not watched Mob Psycho, actually. I remember there was one that kept coming up for me. It was like, I always confuse like the words because it's like, whatever, but like Tokyo Ghoul, because it always automatically played after everything I would play on Hulu or something like that. But Mob Psycho, I've never started. I don't know if I've even been able to try it. What's it stream on? Oh, I'm just chilling. Ooh, that's good. That's a good move. I'm just chilling. Oh, that's what you mean. Chilling? Chilling? Pepper choices. It's named after a chili pepper, right? What the hell? So, just one, right? Just one kind of pepper? That's all we needed. It's on Hulu. Heard that. Every time I watch a different anime on Hulu, I get like three episodes in and realize I don't like it. But this is going to be different. This is going to be it. Have you done any art from Mob Psycho, by the way? You seem passionate about it. One kind of pepper? Well, that's just not interesting at all. This may be it. Maybe it's time. Heard that. Just an underrated one you've been enjoying lately? That sounds nice, though. Peppy time. Various peppers. This is our selection that we will be putting into our vat of various chili items. I have red bells to start off with. A classic. Flavorful, but not too crazy. Mostly, it's like the tomato of peppers. That's how I'm going to describe it. This is like how I'm ranking the peppers. We're going to go mildest to spiciest, too. I also have a couple jalapenos. This season in particular, a lot of the jalapenos just were a little bit too spicy for to eat for human consumption. I loved them. I was able to slice up some fresh jalapenos on the regular and have them be spicy enough that I didn't have to add hot sauce to a lot of things I was enjoying, which I thought was really cool. Also, serrano peppers. Much spicier than jalapenos. Smaller. Usually in a lot of your favorite kinds of salsa verdes, you think it would be jalapenos only. No, serranos are the way to go. Still flavorful. But something that will kind of get your green chili action. And finally, I also got a bit of habaneros. Right in the middle here. Now the habaneros, of course, the kind where you're worried that I just touched them and I'm going to touch my eyeball, it's probably going to happen at some point tonight. I'm going to try to use latex gloves when I hit up my habaneros today. Or in general. Your stomach is not a fan of spicy. Your acid reflux is next level. That's rough. I have no cures. No amounts of cures for that. Other than usually if I'm getting an upset tummy. This is my upset tummy move. If I'm getting like an upset tummy, it's usually because I haven't drank enough water. Ever. My entire life. Just don't drink enough water. Ever. You need goggles? Do I need goggles or gloves? Do I need both? Do I need a full beekeeper outfit to make sure that I don't contact my own body when touching hot peppers? All the above. Most likely. Hydrate. Great timing. That's what I need. Here's a nice hydrate. Very good. Hazmat suit might work one up soon. I had acid reflux from birth. Oh, shit. Should have weaponized it. Stomach issues kept me from going home. Going home from the hospital? Oh. Well, I hope they at least know how to treat it a little bit better now that it's been some time. Hey, it's Arnicus. Yeah, a bee could try to get some pepper juice and then be unable to see where it's going and fly into your eye accidentally. Better get the full beekeeper suit. Of course. Or for sure. Same thing. what is going on? Welcome in, Arnicus. How are you? These are my assorted peppers. Essentially, when we're talking about what we want to do with chili, we're going to take all of our ingredients. I'm going to cook them in the order. This is like an example of vegetables you should cook in order. Hardest to softest. Cook them all down. Throw them in some tomato business. Get some seasoning going. Just make sure that you're like warming up and toasting your seasoning. Cooking down like harder root vegetables like onions first. And then we just keep going. And it's like a layering process until it turns into basically a stew. A bean stew. It's going to be great. You've been putting off surgery. You should go back and get checked now. See, this is why my stream exists, for unwarranted medical advice that you should not adhere to whatsoever because I'm not a qualified professional. But you do you. I wouldn't gloves just change the surface transferring pepper juice to your eyes? That's a good point. I'm probably still going to touch my eyeballs, even if I use gloves. But maybe I'll be able to take off my gloves after I'm done, and I won't just forget about them for 20 minutes, and then 20 minutes later touch my eyeball. That's, I guess, the only way that I could mitigate. it's safe advice to say, you're having a problem, go get it figured out. This is true. I agree with that. What else do I need to get for chili? I have peppers, right? Well, there is one thing that's a little bit different. Which, by the way, for anyone who doesn't know, this is probably going to be vegan chili unless something odd happens. So, vegans rejoice. This might be it for you, finally. Maybe the presence of gloves will make you more aware of it. Ooh, that is possible. Never assume that I'll actually have a good conscious thought. Just assume that I'll probably do it by accident and I'll claim credit gladly for it later. Vegetable broth. That's the thing that is a little bit different that I'm going to use. That's going to be my like primary liquid source. I'm going to use olive oil for my fat source for like cooking down the vegetables. And then bean selection. So I don't know if this is weird. I don't know if this is weird or not, but I actually really like garbanzos or chickpeas in my chili, but I always have to have red beans. Yes, beans. Do you want me to say it? You want me to say it like the thing? The thing, garbanzos are good and red beans, perf combo. Sometimes I put in black beans. If I'm going for that third bean, if I throw in a third bean, like if we're bringing in Sean Bean to die in the end of this chili, I am probably going to choose a black bean. Why does celery keep popping into my head, by the way? The cooking class pour. Hey, welcome in. Great minds and all. I made stream chili too. It's time. Soup and everything. Soup and, it's soup season. I made chicken soup last week. That is absolutely awesome. And it was just because I needed to clear my fridge of vegetables. So I had a bunch of chicken breasts that I also needed to cook off. So I made chicken soup. Grandpa uses like 6 different bean types. That's so many cans of beans. That's so many cans of beans. I am tempted to... No, I'm going to put it in a bowl and we'll gradually make moves. But I was tempted to just throw everything in the pot as I'm done cutting it. But I don't want to like throw things in before I'm ready. Because streaming timing on cooking is different than regular timing, you know? So, moment by moment. Soup is the best way to clear a fridge. I agree. GPA. GPA. No, Grandpa was definitely fighting for his life on the toilet after. Who was living? Are you kidding me? This is freaking fantastic. I hope I... Dietary fiber supplements be damned. Just eat a bit of Grandpa's chili and you are good for at least a week. Sediment that has been built up for years will be gone forever. Moin. RX Bin, welcome in. Morning. Here for a good time, not for a long time. It's healthy, okay? You know what I like to use, though, is actually Spanish onions generally, but I have a white onion. I might have something else. I have a lot of different kinds. You know? Jonas, welcome in. How are you? How are you today? How's it going? What are Spanish onions? Red, yellow. They're technically called Spanish onions. Drewster, hi, how are you? And welcome in Tannerim as well. Put some chocolate into it? Ooh, so if you have secret stuff, let me know. I like bouncing ideas off. I don't put chocolate in my chili. I actually, sometimes certain chilies are a little bit sweet for my tastes. The way that it combines. Dark chocolate is a good move because you know why? There's an alkaline source in chocolate that counteracts the acid of the capsaicin. So it actually, like, they pair up very well. That's why chocolate and chili is often paired. If you don't enjoy good poo, I don't know if we can be friends. You have to at least appreciate it. You need to tweet about it. You need to make a post about it. Gonna lurk and do some cooking of your own? Let's go, what up, see? That's awesome. I'm really happy for you. Do you put meat in your chili? Sometimes. But if I'm making my chili, I like to actually make it vegan. Because when I was in college was when I kind of established that I liked making chili because it was easy, filling, you can make a lot of it. And I had a lot of vegan friends. So I didn't want to leave them out. And then when I had a couple potlucks, the vegan friends appreciated that I went out of my way to make a vegan option for them. I've done like vegan bolognese and then like chili and like different things like that when it was like a potluck. So from their appreciation, my appreciation of doing that thing kind of came out, and I decided that that's how I would make my chili from then on. Give colors and balances to tomato. True. I put like a dash of allspice, to give like that warming, flavor. Gonna lurk and do some, yeah. You had a lot of vegan friends in college. You studied philosophy. JK, sorry. I was a philosophy minor, but none of them were philosophy majors. So, or I had a philosophy minor. I have peeled tomatoes. I didn't get diced, or like broken up tomatoes. I just want them to be peeled. Again, canned tomatoes are generally like the way to go. They're usually canned at their ripest point. And the peeled ones are also, oh no, wait, the peeled ones are also, fuck, Roma tomatoes, generally. Excuse my language, but I realized that it said Italian on there. When you look at your tomato cans, if you see this green line and it says Italian, whether it be what any of the brands, that usually means they put basil in it. So there's going to be basil in this now. Balls. We're going to pretend that there's no basil in it. With everything I'm going to do to it, it'll probably be overpowered by it anyway. So we'll ignore that. All right, extra dash of coffee has been achieved and acquired. We've also got onion and garlic. You also get a better variety of tomatoes when you go canned. Yeah, there's still a few heirloom varieties hanging out if you're looking for fresh, flavorful tomatoes. You won't taste that basil after all that flavor. I hope not. I'm worried that it comes out tasting a little bit too much like just a regular tomato sauce when you have stuff like that. I usually go for as plain as possible, do the work myself if I need to. Okay. One white onion, bell peppers, chilies, and garlic. Essentially Cajun style stuff. Kep had meatless chili and also meatless tacos prepared by other people. Both are very good. You were surprised when you realized there was asparagus in the taco veggies. Ooh. Not overcooked. Otherwise the sulfur comes out. So that's probably really awesome. There's been a lot of good mushroom varieties that I've tried lately. I considered cooking mushrooms this week, which, by the way, sorry, I couldn't stream yesterday. Had something come up and, was a little overworked. So I took the night off. And the reason I took off on Thursday though, is more exciting because we have a special stream to announce for next week. The anticipation is going to kill me. But I will be announcing it in about 30 minutes, by the way. Mushroom was a main ingredient in the tacos. I wonder what kind of mushrooms they used. Getting myself situated. I think we're just going to go for it right now. I got to start shopping or else I'll be here forever, you know? Which isn't a bad thing. Oh, what a life to live where I could just be chopping away and talking, you know what I mean? Not sure if it was catered for us at work. I think that's pretty cool. I think that's pretty cool. You're going to make yourself a cocktail? Do you have any idea what you're going to put in it? If not, I never know anything about what I'm about to do other than what's directly in front of me. So I just start usually like setting up for stream and then I'll press go live because I'm like, I wake up out of my stupor and I realize, whoa, my setup is done. I guess I'll go live now. or I'll like go to work. And then all of a sudden like 100 different drinks will be made. And I'll be like, wait, what do you mean I sold $10,000 worth of liquor today? All right, well, time to go home. Thoughts on the TikTok Negroni drink? Are you talking about the thing that I heard come up last week? The Spagliatos? It's a real drink. Oh, yeah. So who said that? Who got that trending? Who is the one that soundbite is from? I saw it once, and it was completely unrelated to getting a cocktail. Like, the clip that it was playing over, and I was like, what? What are they? They're talking about a Spagliato. What? Which is funny because, yeah, I've made 4 or 5 of those this week. And it's literally the only reason why I can think of. Which that's a whole nother thing about, you know, staying on trends and what's going on. I guess I could do that next week. I could make a Spagliato next week. Do y'all want to see that? Interview with people from House of the Dragon. Oh, which character said that? Also, hi, Komet. How are you? Emma DRC. Is that Rhaenyra? I don't really know. I don't really know actors' names. Which is kind of funny. I generally like if I see Ewan McGregor, I know his name because of so many different things, you know. If I see Ewan McGregor in things, I'm like, oh yeah, it's Obi-Wan Kenobi. It's like Moulin Rouge. What's Obi-Wan Kenobi doing here? He's older Rhaenyra. Oh, heard that. Being a couch potato since double vax today. Congrats. Feel better soon. Hopefully it's just being tired. You definitely try it. I'm thinking about making it because I have to remember to do trends and things like that. But the point is that when you're in food, a lot of times trends and what's going on are extremely important to stay ahead of. Business-wise, business sense-wise, staying in season, knowing when there's events and like holidays that need certain things. Thanks for the lurk, Sam. So the whole aspect of like jumping on trends when they're hot, it's something I'm not unfamiliar with. I was working on my foundational structure of things before I started kind of making sure I'm on top of those. But why not make a Spagliato? So it's not really a Negroni, by the way. There's no gin in it. So you just do Campari and sweet vermouth. And then you top it with Prosecco. I don't think it should just be equal parts. I think it should be a little bit more Prosecco to balance it out. But you catch my drift. It's kind of like put enough Prosecco in it so it tastes good. It's true, my bad. I hadn't known about them before this show. Yeah, I didn't even know. I've never seen a lot of those actors. Usually when it's like a bunch of British people, I just imagine that I'm going to see people from the Lord of the Rings and like the Harry Potter movies involved, or like Simon Pegg. Oh, I'm crying. I'm crying. The onions got me. There's no way I could cut stuff without cutting myself. A lot of it is because when I'm holding the knife, I know where it is. That's really what all it is. You love the new Lord of the Rings show? I didn't watch the last episode yet. I love it too. I do agree that it's not going to catch people. I don't think it's going to catch people as easily per episode. You have to like watch all of it. And yeah, so was the finale. So I want to watch that tomorrow, probably. Maybe Monday. I generally just don't consume media until... Like, I maybe saw, I saw a screenshot of it. Finale was so satisfying. So people that said, I can't get into it. I'm figuring that the best move for them would be to just watch all 6 episodes, like, as in a row as possible. I knew a few who thought it was boring. It's boring if you aren't interested in Lord of the Rings lore at all. And also, if you compare it to other grabby fantasy shows. Not necessarily House of the Dragon, but yeah, a little bit. There's more hardly shocking stuff that happens. Plus, there's a lot more world building happening with the Lord of the Rings show in terms of establishing settings. So that does take a little bit less talking and more walking, you know? Also, I did have a theory when I was thinking about it that there might be a generational gap that people that are older are going to like the Lord of the Rings show more than the House of the Dragon show. If you think about it, 8 seasons for Game of Thrones, like, what is that, 8 years ago, 10 years ago now? How old were people when that show started? And where is the nostalgia factor coming through? Meanwhile, the Lord of the Rings movies, other than the Hobbit series, I mean, dude, that was like 20 years ago. Some people were like babies when those movies came out. And we just know people don't read, right? So, joking, read the books. You'd rent a theater for the day to watch them all in a row? That'd be such a long movie. Because it's essentially a movie. And that's what I brought up. I was like, each individual episode on its own doesn't mean very much. I told somebody that was like open to it. I was like, if you watch them in a row, it'd be like a long movie. Yeah, 8 hours. It's still really long. It's like, oh man. Because that's kind of the progression that I got. It's like a broken up movie. You know? Also, I should be cooking down... I'm going to peel these garlics. Thanks for the hydrate, Sheik. Yeah, I got... I don't want to, like, burn the onions or, like, overcook them. So I'm just going to work on the stuff that takes a little bit of time before I start cooking down everything. Some are over an hour, probably more than 8. Oof. I for anyone who doesn't watch the shows, or doesn't know what we're talking about, there's a new Lord of the Rings show called The Rings of Power or Ring of Power. Is it Ring of Power or Rings of Power? It doesn't really matter. The point is that there's a story in the movies when they're talking about it during the Fellowship where, yeah, they had to forge magic rings for all the kings of Middle Earth, right? They all thought they were doing a great deal. Turns out it was a sour deal from Sauron. And so it's going into the before times, before the Ring of Power was a thing, before we were like, what the hell is that? Oh my God, it's a ring. Oh my God, that evil guy's tied to it. So this is like the long lore of the kings before. I would say it's about 4 or 5 generations before, depending on the species, before any of the movies, any of the people. Sour deal from Sauron? Yeah. You like that? Just thought of it. I'm into deep lore. I've gotten lost in Wikipedia stuff for Lord of the Rings many times, going back. There's a lot. It's a compendium. It's all the way back there. You know? So when this came out and I realized what they were going into, I was like, oh yeah, this is cool. These peppers look really good on my computer screen. I'm glad. Assumed it was like 1,000 years before the Fellowship. But yeah, have deep dive. Yeah, it's a lot. It's back when they're like telling stories, like, I'm not going to spoil anything. I'm not going to spoil anything, but yeah, it's a long time ago. I'm curious, have any of you particularly found a fantasy or sci-fi series where you really felt like you needed to deep dive? I've done it with a few things. I mean, of course, I'm pretty sure everyone... Well, if you're new, you don't know. I'm into Star Wars. Turns out I'm into Lord of the Rings. I didn't think I was into comics that much, but apparently I know a lot about a lot of different timelines in Marvel comics, specifically like X-Men and Spider-Man and things like that. Not Rambo. Despite all appearances. You love Star Wars? Yeah, Star Wars is awesome. Have you seen Andor? I didn't watch the last episode. I would imagine it just came out. But I pretty much caught up like 5 episodes. And I think it's awesome. I think it's awesome. I think it's what should have been done with Kenobi. But it's a side story. It's just shot really well. The acting has been really good. I'm enjoying the dialogue. Little bit back and forth with the cutscenes, but it's pretty good. And the lighting, the angles. Yeah, it's really done. It's done really well, I think. But talking about deep dives, I think that the thing that I deep dove with Star Wars was like the old Republic stuff. Because there's a whole extended universe that they tossed in the trash immediately. Once they realized they were going to make a new trilogy. And part of that, which technically hasn't been put in the dumpster fire yet, because they haven't touched the super old stuff, even like way before the rise of Anakin Skywalker, you know? There's a whole period of time when basically the Sith and the Jedi were equal in number. And in fact, equal in their beliefs and how they stood with each other. And a large part of it was the early mappings of the galaxy as they knew it, too. So there's like a whole section of that lore that's like super cool. Right around the Sith War and the Great Hyperspace Wars. A lot of that lore was found in some of it is in Knights of the Old Republic, the video games series, and then also Oh, hi there, Cheese. Hi, Mahal. Happy belated birthday. Is anyone taking notes on the secret recipe? Thank you for reminding me I haven't said anything that I'm doing out loud. sound bites. Ooh. There's probably going to be some overdubbing if I make a video of this. Thank you. How are you doing? Hope you're well. I am doing well. It's a late Saturday, but we're here, we're hanging, banging, doing the thing. Making secret chili, kind of chopping things up as I go along, seeing what happens. But, hear me out. I think we're about at the point where I don't have to worry about peeling garlic or, like, chopping onion. So... we can kind of move along. We'll chop these as we go. And what else can I do? And then we're also going to start heating up some oil. So that we can get our, onions cooking. I'm just using a fully pledged olive oil. Banging? Yeah, I'm almost hanging bang. We're just gonna get that party started. Hi people. Hi Sue. I'm making chili though. I hope that's acceptable today. Rather than soup. Soup, you have to be making a soup soon. I believe it in my heart. And what is it? Is it chowder? I swear to God, it's the red one, isn't it? I'm so sorry. I know that comes off as an attack, but it's not. It's out of kindness. It's inferior. That's okay, I like chili. Okay, good. We're gonna glaze over what I just said. Okay. I'm missing something. I'm going to need salt, so we're going to grab that. I'm going to need probably a bunch of other seasonings that are going to go onto the onions as they're softening. So let's start pulling them out and putting them in front of me. Oil is heating. That's the point of this angle right now, okay? But in terms of seasonings... Am I ready? I don't know. I don't know anything anymore. I'm actually going to pull out to this because I want to talk about what kind of pepper I'm going to be using. I don't have particularly the regular kind of chili powder that I would be totally okay with using. I think the regular chili powder, totally fine. But I do have Korean chili flake, known as gochugaru. I have chipotle, ground chipotle powder, which of course is aged jalapenos, but it's a little bit sweeter in smell and tasting. We also have red crushed chili flake. Yeah, everyone send your favorite heart emote to Soup and Cookies, please, because she deserves it. That is my call. I say that is true. I also have granulated garlic, ground garlic, and my regular pepper grinder that also has coriander involved. We do need some other stuff. 1 second. Uh-oh. I also have Aleppo pepper. I'm going to use it because why not? It's really good. It's essentially like an espalette. Oh, wow. It's like an espalette. Candied kiwi, hi. Thanks for sending the hearts out. Yeah, Aleppo pepper is something to be fired up about because it's a fire pepper. I'm letting my oil cool off a little bit because I got it too hot. It started smoking. So this is what I get for not being prepared. The one thing about chili is it does take a lot of different kinds of seasonings to come together. Oregano, like dry herb ingredients. Specifically, oregano is mostly important. But then you get all your chili powders, your garlic. Onion powder is also really good. I do have some onion powder. Welcome back, Shawnee. One of my favorites for fall winter. Yeah, it's time. So I figured if I set it up now, we can show right now. You can see all my mistakes live, like me almost burning my oil immediately. But we do want our dried spices and the onions to go together. Oh, preferably with a working camera. How long will this last you? Probably the week. That's it. So we did one full white onion in there. We're going to do a metric fistful of salt. Yeah, these are the measurements we're going to work with, okay? Get used to it, because this is how we do it here. I'm going to poke at my Korean chili flake, because it's a little bit stuck to the bottom. Yeah, another metric fistful of gochugaru chili flake. You saw a dude with a palm tattoo of a circle that measured a tablespoon. Okay, that's pretty cool. Are those onions in the pot? Hell yeah, they are. Let's stir the pot, if you will. With some olive oil, salt, and gochugaru chili flakes so far. I think that's pretty cool, actually. Yeah. It's like the most useful tattoo I've ever heard in my life. And I saw a tic-tac-toe board once. Some regular red crushed red pepper flake. Was so shook. That's awesome. And I'm going to use some of this chipotle. It's a little bit sweeter. Kind of gives that chocolate note we were talking about earlier. That's another metric fistful. Again, if we under-season or do anything less than we want, that's fine at this point. We can fix it later. Never had more of a desire to get a tattoo. The longer I exist, the more likely it is that it's going to happen. Another metric fistful. This one's Aleppo pepper. Got a good pepper situation going on. By doing it here like this, we get it in a way that we can like toast up all of our spices while we're doing it. I continuously stir whenever I can to avoid the burning of the onions. And I put my little spoon in my cat spoon holder. And then we're going to do, I don't know, some like, maybe like 20 whirly-doos of black pepper with coriander mixed into our grinder. You need that spoon holder? I don't think I got it anywhere crazy. Actually, it might have been a gift. We told our, like, one of our family members that we like cats once, and then everything was cat-related. Did I do garlic? Ooh, that's spicy. I could smell it. Okay, we're gonna do another metric fistful of garlic powder slash granules. What's the difference between kosher salt and regular salt? I mean, it is blessed, but really the reason is that it's a different, like, grain. It's a different coarseness. You know? I am noticing, so if you notice this too, I noticed that because I've added spices and everything else, my onions are starting to dry out a little bit. I'm going to add a little more fat. A little more olive oil. And give it another stir. And we are on low, pretty much like medium to low heat at this point. You want it sizzling, but you don't want it like cooking. You don't want it like rolling. Could probably be found at your local Ross, TJ Maxx. Or like you could... Or you could be like me, and, I pushed the wrong button. Well, we'll find out where that goes. Oh, look at that. Or you could be like me and find out that you just got a box of coloring pencils and a sweatshirt from the airport as they were on their way to you because they forgot that you existed. Are you going to spill your chili when you're done for the final touch? Oh, Kevin, I'm actually, not. No. But I am going to make that joke my entire personality for the remainder of the stream. Hey, y'all, you ever watch The Office? It's a good show. There's a lot of funny looks that break the fourth wall where you stare at the camera. So relatable. This goes out to everyone who never watched it. You're Pam. I think I'm gonna sneeze. Oh my god. All these peppers and onions and olive oil and salt and garlic grounds. Bless you. Thank you. Actually, I'm going to be honest with you. I do have a character I related to with more than any of the other ones, and it was Creed. Yeah. Don't worry about it. Oh my god, I feel like I'm gonna just be crying for the rest of the stream. Unrelated to my feelings this time. Also, I just realized that you can't see what I'm doing, but that's fine. You know? You love how many characters were the same first name as their actors? I know, right? Yeah, that's his actual name, right? We tried to watch The Office and my brain just didn't get it. Hopefully I'm still allowed in your stream. Everyone's still allowed in my stream. You don't have to like The Office. In fact, I'll give you credit if you tell me that you don't like The Office. Because I'll be like, well, at least you got it faster than I did. I still watched it like 10 times in a row. But eventually you realize all the characters are pretty problematic. I hate The Office. All right, Mons. First chat of the evening. I hate what you're talking about right now. JK, I've never seen it. That's okay. I actually would have respected you, I respected you an equal amount if you told me you hated it or if you told me you liked it, because that makes no part of the calculation. How are you, Canelo? Did you know? Did you want to know? Do you want to know? Did you want to know? Do you know? No? Do you want to know that this particular recipe is vegan? That's right. It's vegan for our vegan friends so that we can all enjoy it together. You know? Yeah. It's vegan. Es vega. Es vego. You know Vegan the Carpathian? Hero of Ghostbusters 2? I watched it, but I'm not a super fan. It was fine. It was fine. Yeah. I actually agree. And another one that comes up a lot is Parks and Rec. Parks and Recreation. I actually think that show was hilarious. There's like a lot of little skits thrown in. Some social aspects of things, which is kind of cool. Social injustice things. I actually really like Parks and Rec. It was awesome. And I don't like it, you know, like the whatever. Like, my favorite characters in Parks and Rec aren't necessarily the main characters. It was like the guys in Animal Control. were my favorite characters. I'd say it's one of my favorite shows. Oh, hell yeah. I just chopped up like 40 cloves of garlic. I don't think that's an exact measurement, so you're going to have to take my word for it. And put them into our onions and pepper situation. To recap, also, go follow Canella. Horror watcher extraordinaire. Great tastes. Would recommend. Amazing. Funny. Great to hang out with. And I love hanging out and watching and hearing the excitement over the scary videos that are being done. Put exactly 40 cloves of garlic into the chili. Yes, this is 40 cloves of garlic. Please, nobody do that. I keep forgetting to turn this back on. In here, to recap what we're doing, I put an entire... we heated up olive oil to like a simmer status. We put in white onion, salt, granulated garlic, chipotle, ground Aleppo pepper, ground crushed red pepper, some ground black pepper and coriander, and Korean chili flake known as gochugaru. I also put in about, I'm going to be honest here, I think it was like 10 cloves of garlic. And a little bit more olive oil twice because I realized it was drying out. So now that we've done that, we can get to the pepper situations that we know and that we love. Because it's chili. Let's throw some chilies in here, you know? So as this is going over yonder, we'll turn it down low because we don't want to burn our onions or our garlic. Is that Glow? Hi, Glow. Cheese, you have a huge favor. Say no, it's okay. But can I see your pet cam really quick? I don't have a pet cam on my cooking streams, dude. I did it on my gaming streams because Azteca would show up and sit next to me and still does. Like if I'm editing or if I'm gaming or if I'm watching all of your streams, like yours, Glow. If I'm watching your stream, Azteca's usually right next to me. And also, hi, it's good to see you. Have you done it recently? You're searching your VODs. It's not on any active VOD. I actually haven't done a gaming stream in months. Months, but that's coming back, by the way. Because I want to. That's the only good reason to do anything when you're streaming is because you want to, you know? Let me put this back. Thanks for the shout out. On your stream. I was going to give you one on mine. Look, it's Glow. It was a bit? Oh, okay. Yeah. Think I don't see it? Thanks for the lurk, Glow. Go follow Glow. Very kind person, and that's what's important in life, isn't it? Glow, I've heard of him. Yes. Once or twice. So while we're here though, back to chopping. Just like switching my cameras a million times. You know? Right now I'm breaking down red bell peppers. Our pepper situation that we have bell peppers, we have jalapeno peppers, and the bells I'm going to throw in first because they're bigger, take a little bit more time to break down. We're basically doing an example of cooking and chopping things and cooking them as their cooking time suggests, you know. How long does it take to cook something? If it takes longer, it goes in first. That's all we're doing. That's how I make my chili, and that's it. I'm like, hey, I got a ton of peppers. Hey, I got some onions. Hey, I got a ton of garlic. Awesome. And then we're going to get our canned tomatoes, which are already pretty soft, and top them on top of everything else. But right now, we're doing the flavor. We're dropping in the flavor. So when I chop my bell pepper, I kind of go about an inch away from the stem. That way it cuts most of the rib off of there. I don't really care if I have the ribs in there, but if we're going just for flesh, it's easier to kind of work your way around so you can kind of just unravel and you're already like ribless, you know? This is actually a common way of figuring out how to julienne your bell peppers. It uses most of the fruit too, so, or vegetable, I should say, but it works. These also have a little bit more moisture in them. So when by chopping them and adding them in first, when our onions were kind of drying out from cooking them down and sweating them, this will add a little bit more of our situation. Back we go. A little stir in. Remember, our garlic went in significantly after. It went after. We went onions, then spices, then garlic. Garlic cooks faster than a lot of them. Then coming back. Oh, you know what? Still figuring out how. It seems that I have to come back to that screen first before I can go back. Okay. In terms of our jalapenos, I'm going to do two cuts, quarter turn each away so that it's like into fours like this. And then I'm going to chop it down. I just want them small. Once I get to the very seedy part, I'll stop and I'll cut off the sides of them. Just occurred to me that I feel like I don't have time to cook, yet I will sit and watch someone take the time to cook. You know, that's actually one of the reasons why I really want to emphasize my cooking streams too. Yeah, it's my bread and butter, no pun intended, but it is kind of intended at this point. It is my expertise by force as I made it my profession. But it's something that I can be creative with, that I can share. But most importantly, it is one more thing that I can do on stream that involves doing something that I like to do and to take care of myself at the same time. I wouldn't make very interesting stuff all the time if I wasn't streaming. So I consistently try to make something cooler all the time. Because I get to hang out with all y'all. And it just so happens that we're here hanging out, you know? So isn't that nice? Okay, we got a lot of jalapeno seeds that didn't make it in, which is fine. I'm totally not wearing gloves while doing this, by the way. Is it too late? I mean, I haven't done the hottest peppers yet. It's a good smell. It's a very good smell. These are the most fragrant portions that we're doing. Garlic, peppers, onion. I'm gonna rinse my hands really quick, and then we're gonna work on serranos. Okay, but also, you've heard me say a couple times, hey, I'm running out of moisture in my pot here. At this point, you can start adding a little bit of vegetable broth for some liquid. Just a little bit, though, because all you're trying to do is make sure that the bottom of the pan or the pot is not dry. If you put in too much, you're going to start just boiling the things that you want to be more like roasting. I might save. I don't think I need all of these. I'm going to save, like, two of them. Because I have these habaneros, too, so. With serranos, I like to keep them in circles, too. I could chop them up really small, like I did with the jalapenos. But I just think it's more fun to have full circles going on with the serrano peppers. So I spent last night taking care of my brain a little bit by playing video games. And when I was doing that, it actually helped me focus a lot more just on life stuff.
Is awesome.
But I have some recent developments in my ESO playing where I'm becoming rich in my favorite game, Elder Scrolls Online, as of like last night. Kep says, I love your streams. You inspire me to think from a different perspective beyond fast food. I'm at a stage in life where healthier decisions are very important. I've actually thought of things you've talked about on stream while I've been at grocery shopping before. See, that is so cool, Kep. And proud of you for switching your way of thinking, because it takes a while sometimes and change doesn't happen overnight. So every little step you take is a good one in the right direction, especially if it's towards a goal or something that you enjoy. And this is probably going to be the spiciest chili I've ever made. You know how I know? It's because I'm putting habanero in it. I never put habanero in it. But I have decided this is what's going to happen. Yeah. I'm just going to use two habanero. I have a feeling if I use all of them, then I'm actually going to be mad at myself for making the hottest chili on the planet. Which is a whole nother thing. Whole nother issue with that. Okay, doing another stir. It's our flavor base. Fry Alive, what's up? California Reaper chili? No, just habanero, serrano, jalapeno, and bell pepper so far. I have three more serranos and two more habaneros if for some reason I don't think it's hot enough. I'm having this weird feeling that I should try it. So, I don't know. I'm going to try it. You know? Oh, this is the pepper. This is the... This is just the beginning. It's definitely hot enough. It needs a little bit more seasoning in terms of salt. So we're going to do another metric fistful of salt. We can adjust the salt level later on too. It's very important not to oversalt at first. Just enough to like get the vegetables breaking down because you added salt, which causes the cell walls to break easier. And kind of binds flavors. You can also use less salt if you cook with it. If you use a little bit along the way as you go, you overall will end up using less salt because it will taste salted enough. Raw salt flavor at the end is not the ideal situation in general. Oh God, autoface is still on. I didn't use gloves. And I just realized. So now we're going to go in with the beans, because the beans also need to heat up and get broken down. Which does require us to rinse the beans. I do mine in the sink. I don't know how you all rinse your beans, but I literally, if it's sitting in water like this, I'll dump it out into the sink, I'll fill it with water, dump it out, fill it with water, dump it out. That's pretty much it. Red kidney beans in first. Usually drain, but don't rinse. That's okay, too. The aquafaba, or the water that it sits in, gets some of the protein from the beans out of them extracted. So it does kind of act like a thickener, too, when you do that. If there's a little on there. Hello? Connor Carbonara is here. Let's go. Sorry, I was opening a can, so you know how sharp these can be. What's up, yo? Thanks for the hydrate, too. How are you? I'm multitasking. I'm welcoming you while stirring my beans. Connor Carbonara, how are you? How is your stream? What's going on? Thank you for the raid. Bringing a few friends over. I just added some red kidney beans to a lot of flavor. We have habanero peppers. We have serrano peppers. We have jalapeno. We have red bell pepper. Garlic. Tons of it. White onion. Etc. Just made 22 servings of loaded bolognese. What makes it loaded over a regular one? Loaded? Like cheese? Not like me, but like other stuff. Thanks for the raid, yo. Yo, Connor Carbonara is a food and drink streamer as well. Should definitely go check the stream out. Hey, I bet it was awesome. That's a recipe for a fire. Yeah, well, I'm just trying to feel it. I'm trying to feel alive. You know what I mean? Welcome in, Just Chris Gemini. Just trying to feel alive. Everywhere. I hope it was good. I'm sure it was. Because loaded bolognese sounds great. Because bolognese, I know, is awesome. Did you put it over spaghetti? But also, thanks for the raid. I know with cooking streams, it takes a lot. And you have a lot of cleanup to do. So if you need to lurk and just kind of chill, thank you so much for the raid and bringing friends over. Everyone who just came over, hi. My name's John, also Cheese. I stream cocktail creation and cooking, and today we are doing my secret chili recipe. Secret to everybody, including myself, because I have no idea what my recipe exactly is. I just do things, and then out the other end comes great chili. So we're going to do that, and it is chili season, and it is vegan chili as well, just because it happens to be. Cheese on top. but also finely shredded veggies like carrots, sweet potatoes, and beans like cannelli. Ooh. It's like a bowl of nacho. You have taken away all of my sexuality. Or given me new sexuality. Behold. At the other end comes Great Chili. Yeah, you know. Thanks for that. Great to see you. It's great to see you too. Thanks for coming over. Thanks for the raid again. Yeah. Enjoy the food. So I just added a can of garbanzo beans. I like garbanzo. I like it in my chili, and here we go again with another metric fistful of salt. This is because I added the garbanzo beans. They're going to absorb the flavor, or just all the beans. They're going to absorb all the flavor and the salt out of any liquid that is floating about. As it's cooking down, it should be softening up as we go. You can do slow cooker versions of this, which is very, very good. I think it's awesome. And that behold clip is actually why I started watching your streams. Oh, thanks. Wait, what time is it? Oh. I am excited because I used to do a lot of like skits and like setups with my OBS and everything, which is why I know how to do what it is that I have to do. Well, I wanted to set something up upcoming, kind of scary style because it is October. And I also realized we haven't done anything with this whiteboard yet. So I wanted to announce what I'm going to do this Thursday. We have a cooking stream, a solution stream. Yeah, once in a while, we actually talk about the science, history, and cultural significance of things and the food that we're choosing. Well, this Thursday, I've done something a little bit different planned. This isn't this. Just chilying was the only one. I want to show you what's going on here. Because I think my Twitter should have posted it already. I know. Hold. We're announcing a stream for this Thursday. Hold. For one moment, I'm going to run on over to our cafe. Oh, no. No, I'm not. Just kidding. Yes, I am. Only so that I can pull this out for you really quick. Right here. this Thursday, we will be doing Space, the Final Frontier. Scary space food and cocktails. I will be in space. I will be doing my thing as the lead scientist of an unknown expeditionary food division. And I highly recommend y'all come through. I just posted this on my Twitter. It will be on... it will be on every other social media. But it's going to be sick. I'll talk more about it. We've got almost a week until it comes out. If you can like it or retweet it, that'd be awesome. The post is right there in the chat. Cheese in space! And it's going to be a lot of fun. So I hope y'all can make it. Because it'll be awesome. Okay. But I digress. We have food to make. And get this out of my face. This is in my face. I don't like that. Okay. All right. We're making food, though. Thank you all for listening briefly. We've only done beans and flavor so far. Crust to dust. Welcome in. The recipe's not a secret anymore. Or is it? Do we even know what I've done so far? I know that's very hot, and I just put it in my mouth. Wow, it is spicy. But the beans have softened up. It is properly seasoned. And now it is time to add our canned or peeled tomatoes. I do like my my chili to be a little bit chunkier, like on the chunkier side. I just think it's more fun. So I usually will avoid putting too much extra liquid into it. If I need to loosen it up, that's why I have the vegetable broth. So we're gonna add in a whole can of peeled tomatoes. So really, we have used enough of our extra flavor situation that we can use two cans. Not the bird, the amount of our canned peeled tomatoes. And as a helpful reminder to everyone, whenever you are opening a can that requires you to use a can opener, do not use your fingers to get the lid off of it. Get a butter knife, get something else, poke it up, gently pull it out. You're asking for trouble. Even if you've done it 100 times before, totally fine. You are asking for trouble if you don't use a tool. Gently pull it out. Come on, Sue. Come on, I'm trying to be serious here. Just kidding. Now I'm doing a metric fistful of oregano. This is like whole oregano, so I have to like grind it up in my hand as I do it. But a lot of oregano. This is our like final seasoning pass. I'm not going to salt it anymore until I know what it tastes like in the final product, because it is going to reduce down a little bit. So we do a lot of oregano. I also need allspice. You know what I did actually also forget about is ground onion powder. You need like a whole metric ass fistful of onion powder in there too. How can I make this recipe safe for my bearded dragon? you have to remove all of the Kevin Costner. I'll let you figure that one out. This is the funniest comment I've read in a long time. Because I don't know how to answer that. V Beans, hi, welcome in. That's why. Holy cow. Holy cow. I lost my allspice for a second, but I... Oh, nope, that's nutmeg. Okay. Allspice? Allspice. And one of the cans on the fridge. That's where it all went. So just a little bit. A good hefty pinch. Making a curry? No, making chili. Hefty pinch. A little bit goes a long way. So we've done oregano, ground onion, and allspice on top of the canned tomatoes that are on top of all of the sauteed items that we made from before. Now we're going to start the stirring process on that. So it all incorporates. We're pulling... Make sure you scrape the bottom when you stir these. And as you do it, and as it heats up, the peeled tomatoes, the canned peeled tomatoes, will start to break up a little bit too. All right. Now I'm actually going to turn the heat up. And I'm going to get it up to a simmer so that I can guarantee that the whole tomatoes start to break. Sometime you need to make a dish based on the food related to chat usernames. Half the chat seems to be food related. Well, that just makes me happy, though. I trust food related names more than anything on this platform, because at least I know people have their priorities straight when they just first got here, you know? Not here, just on the whole website. You can trust me? I'll try. Bacon Zits, please don't do my name. Ooh, now I have to. So we can make something with beans, with bacon, with soup, and with cookies, and also with crust. No one said that I can't use crust as an ingredient. Maybe not dust. But we'll try our best. Actually, what would that make? And with Chef Orlando, I could make something with Orlando. I'll tell you what. Sup is sound. Sup? Yeah, is sound food? Yeah, I'll just yell at it. That's how I make my mashed potatoes. I don't know if any of you knew that. But my mashed potatoes only succumb to yelling. Aggressive yelling. How are you, JM? Good to see you. Bacon bean soup in a bread bowl. Ooh, see? I already like that idea. Cheese is a dragonborn. That's how I cook. Fuzzro does this. Have enough heat. You know? Cookies can be crackers. Kind of. Cookies can be crackers. Cookies can be wafers, right? You got Nilla Wafers out there in the wild doing something. I don't know what. Azteca, please. My hands have too much garlic and onion on them. I don't know. That'd be cool. Yeah, Azteca's at my feet. I had hot pepper hands. I don't want to accidentally get pepper stuff on her fur and then have her lick it and be upset or something. So I didn't pick her up. Speaking of the Dragon Board comes, I've been learning that song. It's basically the Skyrim theme song. It's really good. And I'm enjoying it very much. And I do have my vegetable broth in case my liquid reduces down too much. But right now, we're coming up to a simmer. We're going to let it kind of like sauce out, hard simmer for a little while. It'll reduce down. We'll taste it to make sure the salt level is good. If we feel like we have to add anything else, we'll do that. But it's all coming together, y'all. Which means that I should be thinking about the fact that I don't have any rice made right now. I'll make some while we're doing this in just a second. But right now, I want to get this all heated up and stirred up, you know? Inhaled that water. Also, in my game of choice, Elder Scrolls Online, I just joined a trading guild. That was my news for that. Which made me more gold than I have ever had in my possession. In the entirety of the game, in one night, all of my things that I put listed on the guild trader sold. I'm just like, oh my god. So now I can buy all the things I want and look cool doing it. And I'll just get more stuff to sell. And that means that I'm entering my final stretch stages of my main build. So, strongest character I've ever made. On a new platform. Strongest character I've ever made. The goal is to have clips now out there where just players are just absolutely awful. Do you put beans in the chili? Yeah. We did red kidney beans and garbanzo beans. Beans, out of your name expertise, what kind of bean would you choose in the chili? Also, Cheese, I read your Cuda board message. It was so thoughtful. What the fuck? Sometimes I think when I'm typing things. Every so often. Especially if it's being kind to somebody who deserves it. For instance, I once typed out a message that said, I want to make an entire electronic drum kit of the sound of you choking on your own finger. I stand by that message. It had a lot of thought. Soup would have deleted it immediately. Don't worry, it was to Glow. Who was here earlier? Cheese, are you doing okay? No. Nope. Not one bit. But imagine, if I had an electronic drum kit, right? It's just like... But it's like, you know, I think it would be hilarious. Did it explain it better? Oh, it's a lot of science. Wait. I'm gonna taste our liquid here. Our boiling hot liquid. Oh my god. Glow choking on the finger soundboard. Yeah, exactly. Obviously, that's what I'm talking about. You ever try to eat something and burn your lip and know that it's going to show up the next day? That didn't just happen. Everything still sound okay? Because I just realized that I did the lighting something on my stove thing. He definitely knows what the bulb is. We try our best. Sometimes we don't show up to health class. All I want to know is what were they going for? You know? What were they going for? In The Legend of Zelda, that like offshoot timeline, you know, Link wanted to catch them all. Which timeline? Majora. Why is it a mask? Hydrate. Thank you. I refused. Thank you also, Sheik, for the hydrate. I refused to finish that game until I had all of the masks, so I know your pain. The multiple timeline thing in Zelda is fabricated by fans trying to piece together things that developers and Nintendo never intended to be there. I say it's all the same game. They just went head empty mode and made games. They're like, we had a dungeon crawler, we just put this character sprite over it. We didn't ask you to call it Link, you know? I don't know. I think they had some intent. They didn't intend to make more than a couple games, I think. And I think that was where it's like, early on, you're like, what is going on? He was the secret Link. He's the Link to the past. I stand by my theory right before Breath of the Wild came out, that it's a cyclical timeline, and Breath of the Wild is going to be timeline-wise before any of the other games. Putting them all together is ridiculous. That's true. Some of them are clearly like, this is... Oh my god, it's so spicy in here. I'm breathing in spicy. Clearly, they're not really all together. That's true. But I think Breath of the Wild and Breath of the Wild 2 is going to segue into Skyward Sword timeline kind of thing. And then also A Link to the Past, and then also Wind Waker, and then all of that. Because all of that is... It makes sense, you know? It gets confusing. That's where Breath of the Wild is going to fill in that blank right now. Or Breath of the Wild 2. What are they calling it? They're calling it Tears of the Kingdom? Do you love theorizing about it? Yeah, I mean, I love the deep dives. I actually did do a deep dive on Zelda lore because I just think that's fun to read all that stuff, you know? Tearing that kingdom up, you know? Have you played Twilight Princess? That's my favorite Zelda game. Twilight Princess is my favorite one. I played most of them. I did not play, like, Minish Cap. I didn't play, like, those other ones. Twilight Princess is my favorite one, though. Because it's a continuation of Ocarina of Time, and I liked the art style, and I liked the controls, actually. I liked the motion controls. And I liked the fact that it tied in the reincarnation aspect of things. It, like, let you know, like, oh yeah, you know, this is just a thing that happens. If you haven't played A Link to the Past, I did. That was one of the first games I played. Hi, Yonti. Welcome in. Good morning. You hear Zelda talk. You do. If you have Nintendo Online, I do. Oh, it's free? Oh, that's a fun fact, Soup. Soup says that A Link to the Past is actually free on Nintendo Online, if you have it. Which is, I think, a really cool thing. It's your fave? Everyone gives us so much shit. No one can give me shit for anything. I stand by my opinions on purpose, because I thought about them already. It's literally my favorite Zelda game. Oh, hell yeah. It's a good one. I should turn this burner off. I'm not using it. Just like gonna put my hand on it or something. So like, I need to make rice, but I want to talk about Zelda. Yeah, I think, like, what are your, like, I'm always gonna see the same ones. The reason that I think it's a cyclical timeline is because I played A Link to the Past, and there's dialogue in that game that tells you that the world was flooded at one point. Also, it was reclaimed by the wild. Also, there is, like, killer robots that happened at some point. That's in A Link to the Past. So, A Link to the Past, from what... This is when it got my thought process going, and then I just went down a rabbit hole thinking about it, and I'm just like, oh my god. A Link to the Past is after A Breath of the Wild. A Breath of the Wild is after Breath of the Wild. And then I'm just like, oh, and then I went, oh, and then all of a sudden I got to that conclusion. I love Zelda games. I don't ever hate any of the games. I fucking hate the mechanics of playing Skyward Sword. That's controls, not game itself. Yeah, it's literally meant for the Wii. Like, that's why it's so awkward to do on controller. It's meant for you to, like, do this with the Wii controller. But, like, I thought Skyward Sword's story was really cool. A little bit slow and draggy because you have to go and fly in between a lot of things to collect things. But that's also fun to me. I like traveling in games. It's immersive. But, like, I also was, like, kind of, about the stuff. I did think the whole Master Sword lore was really cool with it, though. I was like, oh, and then I was like, oh, and then I got, oh, yeah, exactly. Stab and twist, yeah, exactly. Tracking back-to-back same realm 42 times is a bit tedious. Yeah, that's the thing, like, you just have to drop in just to, like, to the same spot, basically, just to do something else. It's like, dude, just ask me to do that while I was already there. Please. It's like, come on. Rice. Keep forgetting. Your first Zelda game was Spirit Tracks on DS. Oh, sick. I never played that. I didn't have a DS. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. JM gets it. JM knows the exact instructions. That's actually very similar to my instructions on how to make this chili. Believe it or not. You love the lore of Twilight Princess? It's cool to have, like, a second mirror world, you know, that you need to have the opposite in order to have your paradise Hyrule existence, you know? Something, something gods and goddesses. I'm scraping the bottom of this pot really quick, by the way, to make sure that nothing that sank to the bottom is burning. I think we're cooking down. I think we're cooking right now. This is going to be done sooner than later. Right now, I'm just cooking it so that some of the liquid and the water starts evaporating that has been generated from all the vegetables we've thrown in here. It could actually withstand to have another... It could have another can of beans thrown in here. Legally speaking, I think it could actually have another can of beans. Un momento, por favor. I just want to see. My bit rate. You must check the bit rate every so often. Very good, yes. Zant is your favorite villain. I don't think I have a favorite villain. I wasn't a fan. I don't even know the guy's name. And Skyward Sword. Does anyone know? I call him edgy anime dude. That's all I got. Hear him? I almost called him Ghislaine. Ghislaine? Did I just say Ghislaine? Like Vati. You like Vati. Oh, yeah, yeah. How do you say Maxwell, the actor's name, Maxwell? How do you say their name? I actually don't know. Vati's cool. I agree. I haven't played Twilight Princess, but recently my friend found a Wii in an electronics trash dumpster, and it works! And I got lots of games downloaded for it. Oh, sick. I still have my Wii, but everything that was on my Wii was transferable to my Wii U, so it's kind of obsolete. Maxwell. Yeah, no, how do you say the first name? God damn it, Jan. All right. Just want a measuring cup. Ghislaine. That makes sense. That's the villain from Zelda, from Skyward Sword. I think it's Ghirahim, like you were saying. It's like oddly Old Testament. Out of, like, all of the other ones, for some reason, this one person has, like, an Old Testament name, and you're like, what? I had a Wii. I got through, like, one-third of Skyward Sword, had to focus on college shit, moved to California, came back. Wii is nowhere to be found. My brother probably sold it, and I'm still upset about it. Yeah, that's upsetting. Skyward Sword is how I canceled my Gamefly membership. For deliverable video games. By never returning it. There were a lot of good games on the Wii. It wasn't a very long lifespan. So what you got in terms of concentration of good games in the short lifespan, pretty good. Yeah, GameFly. I was pretty happy that it came out on Switch just so I could finish it, and then I never finished. It drags. There's a certain point in the game that it kind of drags. I had a broken ankle at the time that I was playing that game. So I had nothing else to do. So I just did that. Just got an ad. Just that. What did you miss? Only that. Nothing really. Same, except my ads aren't done. Soup's got ads. It's a nightmare. V Beans has ads, and they're subscribed. Yeah, my reaction was I had a broken ankle, so I had nothing else to do with Skyward Sword. So when the game starts dragging, I just kind of push through. I used to not have ads at all on Twitch. Yeah, I have Twitch Turbo, whatever the hell they call it. So I pay for an extra subscription directly to Twitch to not have any ads on the entire website. But really, it's so that the only reason I actually got it was so I could change my username color. I don't mind the ads. I hate it when it cuts off a conversation. Yeah, it's true. It's a thing. I do have the no ads for subs thing, but you know, until I get completely consistent with my scheduling and how I do things, I don't expect people to sub, and never expect people to sub anyway. Just appreciate the support of y'all hanging out here, because you make this a great environment for me to be in. I'm going to do a little bit of salt and olive oil, believe it or not, just for a little bit of lube fat into my water. Just hurry up. Thank you for the hydrate. I guess Israeli advertisers didn't look into advertise on Twitch until recently. Oh, interesting. Well, I hope they gave them a good deal. How goes it? Oh, we're working. I'm simmering the chili. It's going. It's working. And I'm currently about to get some water up to a boil to make some rice to go along with it. Hello, everyone. Hi, Lori. Good to see you. Secret chili recipe? Yeah. I don't even remember what I did. I'm going to have to look at the VOD. But I feel like it's going to be good. And once again, I am going to stir to make sure that anything on the bottom is pulled to the top so that it can not burn. I just got a PlayStation ad. Oh, my. Thank you. For actually delivering the correct product to people, Twitch. But anyway, I'm gonna taste this. I'm gonna pick up like a bean. I'm gonna get like a single bean. I wanted to taste the salt level / the spice level. Is it a secret if you're streaming it? If I don't know what I did, I don't know. It's a secret now. That's definitely going to need a little bit more salt, but it also needs something else. I'm thinking it's a little bit of an herb. I might actually have to put more oregano in it. Paprika? We could do paprika. It's just another form of chili. Wait a minute. I think actually I usually do put a lot of paprika in it. Yeah. So we're going to do some paprika. Look at that. Good idea. We're going to do 2 metric fistfuls of paprika. Not smoked, no. Just regular. Sweet paprika. That was a lot. You don't know my life. This is what was missing, damn it. Hi, Sylvan. What's up? Are you scared of flavor? Are you all scared? Are you scared of flavor? How did that much go? I had it vertical. It was like... It was 2 metric fistfuls. It looks like more than it was. That was a lot. Yeah, I mean, y'all have a point. You have a point, okay? But I think it was necessary for many reasons. I love spicy, but a lot of paprika changes that spiciness. I mean, I have several kinds of hot peppers in here. And you're playing ESO, Sylvan? Sylvan, I was just saying a minute ago that I joined a trading guild on PC, and I am quickly becoming wealthy now. And I'm really happy with it. And my build is actually going to come out very quickly. Soon. Maybe celery? I was thinking about celery salt. I'm currently adding also the rice that I had done over here. And once it's in, we go down to a simmer. Okay, I think I sound a little bit better now, maybe, mayhaps. Yeah, I muted it, I'm sorry. We're being boiled alive, I'm so sorry, y'all. Occasionally, from being ungrounded, the mic freaks out when I turn a burner on and off. So, sorry. Thought it was popcorn. I mean, popcorn sounds pretty good right now. I'm not gonna lie. Maybe I'm just hungry. Also, I gotta cover my rice. How do we ground your soap? I have no idea. I've tried to have talks to it. I've tried to take away its car. I've tried to tell it the dangers of smoking weed. And it. It just doesn't understand. What are the most fun things that y'all have been grounded for in your life? No TOS. That needs oregano.
It does taste better, though.
Actually, don't answer that, because I don't know if it's going to be incriminating now that I think about it. Now I don't know if y'all are going to incriminate yourselves. You've never been grounded? Would you believe me if I said never been grounded? You? How? How are you all not grounded? You once put Kool-Aid powder in a toilet water holder thing. See, some of them are fun. Scared the crap out of my parents. That's awesome. You kidding? That's great. Let me see. Do I have a tame one? I One time I was like 4 years old and I went around to all the neighbors and I had like, I would get like, there were like little tiny comic books that would come with like a certain brand of cookie and I was collecting them, right? And then I went around with two of them together and I said, and I knocked on people's doors and I said, you want to see a magic trick? And they're like, yeah. And I would like just throw both of them down. And they would split apart. I'm like, it was one, now it's two. Can I have a dollar? And they're just like, okay. And my mom comes home and I just had like the Sonic the Hedgehog just like blew all around my mouth. Not because I got ice cream. And she's like, what did you do? And I said, nothing. And then she realized, she's like, where did you get the money for this? And I'm like, I went around and got dollars. And she got so mad. Now, not only was I grounded, but I also had to go around to all of the neighbors and apologize to every single one of them for taking their money. She's like, you will never ask for money from random people like that. And I'm like, okay. Also, when you think about it, it's kind of dangerous, but I was an angel. I was never grounded. Lando was never grounded. Kep was never grounded. Crust to Dust says, I got caught mudding a house in third grade, but didn't get grounded. It was hard to get grounded for some reason. You grounded that house. Dirt that you threw. I've only been grounded once for biking street over without alerting my parents. I did all sorts of sketchy shit without getting caught. Oh, La Chancla? Yeah, true. Yeah, I was not scared of La Chancla, apparently. Or I was okay with it. I used to sneak out of my window at night. Actually, okay, my mom is not in the chat. And so, yeah, I snuck out a few times. Got grounded from that. Yeah, mom check. I don't know. I was like, it was really weird. I was thinking about it. It's like I would get good grades and I would be really nice to people, but I would do a lot of like really like troublesome stuff like all the time, you know? Yeah, any moms in chat? I'm sorry, moms. Any of you. It was more of an adventure, you know? That sometimes you wake up in a jail cell. No big deal. I think we're coming close to being done. You're here for the moms? All right. Nobody say if you're a mom anymore. All of a sudden now it's weird. Okay. Oh, you're here for the moms, like as a representative of the moms. Okay, that's kind of cool, actually. I can get behind that. Rice is almost done. I'm gonna fluff it up with a fork, actually. Hi, Dwarf Journal, welcome in. We are in the final stretch. Hydrate, heard that. We're in the final stretch of our chili. And while we're hanging here, I would like to make you all aware of everything. I would like to let you know of something special that we have going on this week while we're here. Actually, I want to see if this works. We're going to do a little test. If you want to see something fun? You want to see something fun? Maybe? Let's try it from here. Hi, it's me. I want to see if this works. For now. Yes, very good. Very good. Very legit. Very legal. Okay. We're just showing up. But under here, we are finally taking this to space. And as we are traveling, I just want you to know that I appreciate you hanging out with me while I make some chili. Appreciate hanging out with y'all. Oh yeah, we're going. We're taking a trip really quick. I just want to test something really quick. It's in space though. So it's a little more difficult to work with. Also, this song is significantly louder than the other stuff that I have on my stream. Wait 1 minute. It's all a test. Okay. Had to drop that. Yeah, we're going. Oh my god. I pushed a button. Now, I'm just going to continue traveling really quick. Hang on. I want to see if this works. It's a little weird. Nope. That was pretty funny though. Okay, what about this? Nope. Wait. I'm working. What about this? Oh, it's me. Okay, well, that's fine. We'll come back to the other thing really quick. But for anyone who doesn't know, this coming Thursday, we are making some scary food in space. 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific time. And I just wanted you all to be made aware that you should come over there. Because I'm going to set up some cool scenes. I'm going to set up some cool activities for us. We're going to hang out. And I'm going to get a bunch of alien produce and pieces of bodies and things like that that we can make some cool food out of. And I'm pretty excited to show you, actually. So, that'll be coming up in just a moment. Now, while I do all of this, and I try and remember whether or not I'm in space, I also say, if you can, please like and retweet my announcement tweet, if you have Twitter. That's in the chat right now. Okay, so this works, but doesn't work the same way. This is something I wanted to test before we move around, but it's something fun, so I figured I'd show you really quick. But also, we're done with the mariachi for now. Just for now. Please turn off. Oh my god. Oh! We're zoomed in! I'm back. I'm sorry. I think we're in a good spot. I think we're in a pretty good spot here. I'm going to put away some peppers. I'm going to turn on my phone cam. I'm going to move on into the bridge. I just really... I just realized you can hear my advertisement in the background. My bad, y'all. Okay, I fixed it. Sorry. I'm back. I'm back. Sorry, I'm Sylvan. You are Sylvan. I think we're just about at the point where our thing is done. Sylvan, this chili. Did that make a fart noise? Sylvan, this chili is, it's vegan, by the way. Okay. So now I need a bowl. Yes, it did. Okay, good. As long as it works. I like this. I'm gonna do that. Unfortunately, though, I actually have to like taste this. Sichuan pepper in your chili? Everyone's just numb. That's awesome. I'm tasting this for to know whether or not it's seasoned properly. Or if it needs anything at the last second. It's probably going to need a dash of salt. All burners are off though right now. Because I purposely scaled back on the salt. Like I use usually maybe like half to three quarters the amount of salt I think I'm going to have to use for the whole thing in any kind of dish until towards the end to make sure that I'm not overdoing it. What other spice are you packing? I have Aleppo pepper, crushed red pepper, gochugaru chili flake, granulated garlic and onion, salt, black pepper, coriander, paprika, and a dash of allspice. It does need a little bit more salt. So one last metric fistful of salt. I'm gonna rinse my spoon now. You haven't tried Aleppo pepper yet? It's like a better version of crushed red pepper. Why do I feel like this is too far away from me? That's the problem. And now that it has been stewing in the pot for as long as it has, then it's all put together like this. It's broken up a little bit. I need my eating spoon. I have to do, so next week, right now we're plating up, y'all, by the way. We're doing the plating process. Next week, I have a wax schedule. I have jury duty on Wednesday, which isn't a day I would normally stream, but I don't know what the heck is going to happen. I'm just going to assume they're not going to need me because I'm going to give them a couple of my liberal points of view, and they'll be like, oh shit, get that guy the hell out of here. You know, I assume I'll just have to tell them the truth, you know? So we'll figure that out, but that's going to throw my whole schedule off. Thursday is when I want to do our cool event. Hopefully that works out. It's going to be great. Friday, I actually have to work late night, which is weird, but hopefully I can do an early stream that day. The problem is going Friday and Saturday, I have a weird work schedule where I don't know if I'll sleep enough, so I can't really guarantee if I'll be around on Saturday. But I'm going to try my best. So I just put in a hefty amount of rice because I like rice in my chili. I hope you all do too, because that's what we're doing. But I am going to put a hefty amount of chili on top of it. You've discovered you're not a fan of sriracha. Oh, well, lucky you. They're unable to keep up with the demand of it. So there's a severe shortage now. Want to root for you to escape jury duty? I hope. It just sucks because I know I would be fair and impartial, which is probably the reason why they wouldn't want me there. All I'm going to say is that mass incarceration is a flawed system and that most people are sent to jail when they shouldn't be. And also, police officers don't exactly tell the truth all the time. And also, weed should be legal. And also, it's like, systemic and inherent racism is a truth that we have to deal with. And I just assume by saying all of those things, they'll be like, oh, fuck, get him out. Like, legality is not a guide for morality. Exactly, Ferris Power. Also, welcome in, Ferris Power. Yeah. I have chili now. I put a little bit of cilantro on top because I wanted to. I don't always put cilantro on it, though, by the way. Chili bowl. I don't know if I did that right. Hang on. Chili bowl. That's good. Let's have a bite and hope that I seasoned it properly, though. I think I did. Looks yummy. I think it looks good. This is my Netflix and chili, as we were saying. Which, frankly, I think that's a better one than this one. No offense, Shawnee. But I think my worst one was the best one that I had. And I just didn't want to believe it. And yes, the worst is sometimes the best when it comes to taglines. Yo! That is good! I also wrote it too fast where I kind of looked like a serial killer. It's vegan! Hell yeah. Wait. Here it is. Oh, it's hot. Like, temperature. Awesome. It's almost so hot that I almost burned my mouth. Also, I was worried that I used too much. Look at the steam coming off of this, too. Like, ignore me. Look at the steam. So, it's very hot. It's awesome. If you wanted it to be saltier, you could, but I don't think it needs it. Good amount of rice on the bottom. Breaks it up. If I want more rice, I just reach down deeper and pull it up. It's pretty spicy, but it's not blowing me out. I can easily taste other things if I wanted to. It's not so spicy that I wouldn't say that I could put more spice on it. I could put more peppers on top if I wanted to. And it would be totally fine. A little bit of the beans have broken up into the mix, which thickens it and makes it nice. But there's still whole garbanzos and whole red kidney beans present. Sylvan, there's a good size to the red bell peppers still, so they're visible and present, which adds to how, like, it all, the context, like, texture of it. You don't want it to be mush, but you don't want it to be chunky. You know, you want it to kind of a little bit break down together so that all the flavors meld with each other. I could eat two bowls of this and still be hungry. And not just because I like to eat a lot of protein these days. This will satisfy and fill people up, especially with the rice. And it's hot, it's spicy, it's hearty. You know, some people will describe stews as something like they want it to stick to your insides. You know, when you eat ribs or something like that, like a comfort food, they say it sticks to my ribs or something like that. You know, it's sticking to my ribs. This is hearty enough that I could say that even as it being vegan, so all the fat is from like olive oil and the beans, it's still very hearty. And I like it. I think it tastes like all the ones I used to have. If you were interested in my inspiration for the recipe itself, it's spicy enough too. It's catching up to me. The more I eat it, the more it catches up to me. It's sticking to my insides and being hot too at the same time. The habanero is coming through now. And that's awesome. Join the Discord. So believe it or not, the recipe influence where I originally got this from was Emeril Lagasse. Bam, dude. His recipe gave me like the baseline, and I put it in the recipe Discord. I put it in that channel in case you want to look at it. And that was me making it like 15 years ago. You know, me making chili 15 years ago. I followed it pretty closely to that recipe, but I didn't do it exactly. And gradually over the years, I've made adjustments and changes to the point where I don't really remember what I do, but I know why I do it. And you just saw, this is pretty solid. I would say this is very close to exactly how I would want the chili to be. Room for improvement? Maybe if I actually had the measurements of the exact things that I put in here, it would come out really well. Also, I changed my mind about it being not spicy enough where you could add it. I don't think you need to add any more spice to it. A lot of times I'm tired of adding more spice or sauce or anything to, because it's not spicy enough, to my dishes. I would like it to be done if I'm going to eat it, and I made it for myself. If I'm making it for other people, I'll scale back and be okay with that in terms of spiciness. So if you wanted it to be like mild, I probably would have used only no habaneros, one less serrano, and it would have been pretty mild. Need to go to work now. Bye, everyone. Bye, Auntie. Have a good day at work. Thanks for stopping in. I appreciate you all being here, seeing me make chili. This was mostly just to announce that I am going to be streaming this Thursday with a cool space-themed alien food deal. But I also had all these ingredients and I desperately wanted to make you all chili. And also the chats have been really cool today. Thank you all for talking with me. Good discussions about everything. You could serve this with some bread, like a toast, if you would like. I'm thinking if I'm going to do a shorter lunch stream on Friday, I might do grilled cheese, because you know what I got? I got a whole sourdough brioche in this bag. And this is my bread of choice because I can cut it real thick and I can do things to it. in order to make it happen. And before I lose something out of my nose, I'm going to take care of that really quick because it's spicy. Well put together. Well done. And now I have probably nearly, I don't know if that's going to work actually. Should scoop it out. I think I have like two quarts of chili now, and I still have a quart of the chicken soup. If y'all follow me on Twitter, you saw it. I think I put it in my Instagram story too, but it was just a picture. Hi Flowerson, welcome in. How are you? Yeah, we got like two quarts of chili. Here's one ready to go right away. I'll put that off to the side. But this is the color I'm working with. Steamy too. Woo! Steamy and spicy. Very happy. This is what I needed. This is what I needed today. It's all vegetables. It's just good. Man. We made chili today, Flowerson. So that I can post up some really nice recipe options for y'all on the old internet. All right. I am all set. I just cooked up a storm here. If you don't mind hanging out with me for just a moment, I'm going to see who's online. Because I don't know what's going on out there. I'm just here. Burn. Damn, this is a short stream, dude. But I just wanted to make my food, kind of enjoy myself, you know what I mean? Let's see who's around. I will be back on Thursday. And I have the hiccups. I need to drink some water. But I also want to eat all of this chili. Were you playing horror games before? Okay. Uh-oh. Pause. Cheers and enjoy chilling. I'm excited. Yo, Starlad, what's up? How are you? We're just about to raid somebody. Short stream today. I'm gotta clean up and rest up and do some stuff, so I'm ready for my day tomorrow. You know what I mean? Just realized I don't have any of my stuff here. Blah. Man, I make a mess sometimes. I gotta clean too, so that's a whole nother thing. I don't think I've had a chance to raid this person before, so I want to. Rum Punch. Very kind person I know from many different communities. Name is Sarah. She, her pronouns. They are streaming GeoGuessr at the moment. And I know it's a good time. So I'm going to send you all over there, and I'm going to lurk while I'm cleaning. I am going to say hello and hang for a bit. So if you like what you see, follows are free. Remember to follow this stream if you haven't already. And I will be happy to be back on Thursday, 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 p.m. Pacific time, for some scary space food. Big theme, big cool things going on. I don't announce things like that unless I know it's going to be awesome. So I do recommend you coming back for that. Let's go with... Hi. Smiley face. As our raid message, remember to take care of yourselves, take care of each other. Do something nice for yourself tonight. Because you deserve it, because it was a tough week. I will see you on Thursday, and I hope you have an excellent rest of your day. Bye. See you later.